There are two distinct material region tools that can be used to apply materials to a specific area of either a floor or a wall. In this video, we're going to look at the floor material region and wall material region tools, a few key settings to be aware of, editing options, and other special behaviors. Let's start off by looking at the floor material region tool, which allows us to apply a material to a very specific area in the floor. You can apply a floor material region by going to Build, Floor, Floor Material Region, and then clicking and dragging in the plan where you would like to apply the material region. The material region will be added based on your default settings. So let's delete this floor material region and take a look at the default settings for the tool. We can access the default settings by going to Edit, Default Settings. If you go down to Material Region, you'll have an option here that says Floor Material Region, and if you're using Chief Architect Premier, you'll have another option that says Wall Material Region. Let's double click on Floor Material Region, where you can see that we have settings to adjust the material layers composing the region, and there's a checkbox here that says Cut Finish Layer of Parent Object. When this setting is unchecked, the material region just sits on top of the floor finish. When this setting is checked, the material region cuts through the floor finish and sits on top of the subfloor. When using the material region tool, if you would like your flooring to be a consistent level throughout the space, you need to make sure the material region layers are the same thickness as your floor finish. Let's check the floor thickness by canceling out of this and going to Floors and Rooms. Go to Floor Levels, double click on First Floor, where you can see that the floor finish is 7/8 of an inch thick. Let's keep this number in mind and cancel out of this dialog and go back to the Floor Material Region defaults, where you can see that the material layers for this tool are 5/8 of an inch thick, which is 2/8 or 1/4 of an inch less thick than our floor finish. So if we want our flooring to be level throughout the wood flooring and the material region, we will need to add 1/4 inch to our material layers. We can do this by clicking on Edit, where you can see that I currently have a tile material selected for use, and then off to the right you can see the material thickness. In Chief Architect Premier, you have controls on the right hand side to add new layers to the material region, move layers up and down, delete layers, and see the total thickness. Also in Chief Architect Premier, you can mark a layer as insulation, and when in a cross-section view and using the auto detail feature available in Chief Architect Premier, Chief will add an insulation fill to the material layer in the cross-section view. Next, recall that we need to add 1/4 inch to the material region. We can do this by either adjusting the thickness of our current layer or by adding a new layer. I'm going to add a new layer by clicking the Insert Below button, which you can see adds a new layer, and then I'm going to change this to be a mortar material by double clicking on the current material, which will pull up the library browser where we can select a new material, and in the search bar I'm just going to search for a mortar material, select it, and click on OK. And then next for the mortar material, I'm going to adjust this to be 1/4 inch thick. And you can see that the total thickness is now 7/8 of an inch, and now when we use the floor material region tool, the material region will cut through the floor finish, sitting on top of the subfloor, and be the same thickness as our floor finish. Let's click on OK, and continuing down the panels on the left hand side, the next panel says Line Style, where we can adjust the layer that the material region comes in on, and how the lines of the material region border should display in your floor plan view. The next panel is the Fill Style panel, where you can give the material region a fill style. For the purpose of this example, let's apply a hatch fill to the material region fill. The next panel is the Label panel, where you can add a label to the material region, and then on the Components panel, you can specify information for reporting the material region to a materials list. Let's press on OK, and then click on Done for the default settings, and then add a floor material region into this area by going up to Build, Floor, Floor Material Region, and then again just clicking and dragging approximately where we would like it to be placed. Next, if you want to get very specific with its position, in the floor plan view you can use the dimensioning tools to dimension it from other objects, or you can use the temporary dimensions. So let's make sure our temporary dimensions are turned on by going to View, and then Temporary Dimensions, and then I'm going to select the edge of the material region, and then dimension it my desired distance away from the other objects. Material regions are polyline-based objects, meaning that with the material region selected, in the bottom toolbar you have a handful of CAD tools that you can use to reshape it, such as breaking edges and reshaping it, adding curves, modifying the corners, and more. Another benefit of material regions being a polyline-based object is that you can draw out simple CAD and convert it to a material region. Let's take a look at a basic example of this by pressing spacebar and going up to our CAD tools and selecting the CAD circle and then clicking and dragging a CAD polyline in the plan and then pressing spacebar and selecting the CAD circle. In the bottom toolbar you can select the option that says convert polyline, and then from here you can specify what you would like to convert it to, and we're going to convert it to a material region and then click on OK. And this is going to get added to the plan based on your default settings, and it's also going to pull up the material region specification, so if you wanted to make adjustments to it you could do so now, but I'm just going to press on OK. And if we come over to the 3D view and zoom out a little bit, you can see how that gets added to the design. Converting CAD to a material region is extremely powerful because it allows you to draw out unique shapes which can add character to your design or account for many common design scenarios. In this picture, you can see that we've used the material region tool to add an inlaid material onto the deck. In this example, we've added a material region to have tile going through the bath and into the shower. In this example, we've taken the CAD polyline tool and shaped it to go around the existing material region by breaking it and dragging out the sides, dimensioning it to be 4 inches from each side, converting it to a material region, and then adjusting the material. Once you've added a material region into a plan, you can add it to your user library to use in future plans by selecting the material region and in the bottom toolbar selecting the Add to Library button, which will add it to your user catalog, where you can then click on it, give it a new name, and then whenever you want to use this material region in future plans, you can simply select it and then click and drag to add it into the plan. Let's go ahead and close out of our library browser, and the next feature I want to go over is the wall material region feature that is available in Chief Architect Premier. If you are using Chief Architect Interiors, you can use the custom backsplash feature as it works nearly the same. The difference between the floor material region and the wall material region tools is that one works on the floor and the other works on the walls. Another difference is that with the wall material region feature, you cannot specify a fill style that is seen from a floor plan view like you can with the floor material region. Let's draw a wall material region and then talk about it. In my 3D view, I'm going to add a wall material region by going to Build, Wall, Wall Material Region, and then click and drag a marquee over a wall I would like to place the wall material region on. If you wanted to be very precise with where it's located at on the wall, you can get into an elevation view, click and point an elevation at the wall, and then use your dimensioning tools to dimension it. In our 3D view, if we double click on the wall material region to open up its specification, you will notice that there is the same checkbox as the floor material region that says cut finish layers of parent object. This setting is also present if you are using the custom backsplash tool. In this case of adding a material region onto a wall, the parent object is the wall, and the tool will cut through the finish layer to the main layer of the wall. Let's open up the wall specification and take a look at the wall type and see what the finish layer and main layer means for walls. So let's cancel out of this, press spacebar, select the wall, and then in the bottom left-hand corner select the open object specification. And then we're going to go down to the wall types panel on the left, where you can see the current wall type that we're using, and if you press on define, here you can see all the different layers that are making up this wall. And you can see that the main layer is a wall stud, and then the finish layer that the material region is cutting through is this drywall that's a half inch thick. Just like with the previous example of the floor material region being the same thickness as the floor finish, it's a good idea to be conscious of the drywall thickness if you want your wall material region to be flush with the wall. Let's go ahead and cancel out of this. And lastly, I wanted to compare some of the functionality between the wall material region tool versus using the custom backsplash tool. So let's make our 3D view to be our full screen view, and then rotate our 3D view so that we're staring at this back wall in the kitchen. Next, let's add a wall material region onto this back wall. So I'm going to go up to Build, and then Wall Material Region, and I'm going to click once on the wall in the area between the base and wall cabinets, and watch what happens. You can see that Chief applied the wall material region to the entire wall. This can be desirable in some scenarios, such as if you have an accent wall or region, but in this case, this is not desirable since the wall material region will be present behind the cabinets when really we want it to cut around the cabinets. Instead, a better tool to use in this scenario is the custom backsplash tool. So let's delete the wall material region, and to use the custom backsplash tool, go up to Build, Cabinet, Custom Backsplash, and then click in that same area above the base cabinets but below the wall cabinets. And you can see how the custom backsplash tool appropriately filled between these areas. And then if you wanted the rest of this wall to have an accent material, now you could use the wall material region tool by again going to Build, Wall, Wall Material Region, and then clicking once on the wall and then dragging its position back so that it's not going behind the cabinets.